That is, if it is there. Now, if you see, this is a link. So you go to there. Now, if I want, I have created a, let me see, overview. Okay, this is an overview. So what I will say, I will need a screenshot of this because that overview is a complete dashboard. If you see a dashboard, because nothing
Okay.
is there, so I'm not seeing that. So if you
Yeah.
can see, I will show you what is a screenshot. So if you are seeing, this is what this, I will just go to. Okay, so we have this. So we need to, your organization must have created some organization. In that, we create a project. Okay, as you have shown, Unison is one of your project. Or then the new, I just missed out. So if I
Fusion,
create a new Fusion, so you are working on Fusion. Okay, now, so similarly, I have just created a test. Or if I want a new project from here, I will create a new project. I will say just. Azure demo. Okay, I've created this visibility because in your organization it will not be public, it will be private. Because only people you give access will be able to view this project.
Okay.
Because if they will do internet, if we do public, public means anyone on the internet can view the project and certain features of the. These are not support, okay? Because it's a free trial, so that's why. But I will make it as public, not a private.
Okay.
But in your organization, it will be. So if they give you any new work that create a new project or something like this, always make it private, not public. Because for organization, it should be always private.
Okay.
Okay, so I say that as a... And I will say create. So this is the first screen what you have shown. That is, this is a project, and under this, these are the screens of the project. So summary, because there is nothing, so it is only showing welcome. But in your summary, it must be showing in dashboard, as you have I have seen this, there are charts or everything. So dashboard. Is there. So what we create a dashboard, okay, build history or assign to me, allows team members to quickly view and manage this. So this is all burn down or burn up charts, whatever it is, chart for test plans, chart for work items. So the dashboard is something which from so that your manager or somebody can, and who is managing a project, is able to see what the team members are doing. What is the stage of there? Okay. So it is just a dashboard. Then we have a wiki. Wiki is something. Creating a project wiki, that means documentation. We can keep a documentation here also. We can keep a best practices here. So this is being there on the wiki. Wiki is that document related to this project is being up, is being placed here.
Yeah.
Okay. This is a board. Board is something. So work items means when we are dividing it into a small parts, okay, entity, creating that suppose let me tell you, suppose I'm working on a project, okay, I'm working on a project in which I have to create a application login page, okay.
Okay.
So I'm just taking a general things. So you or I am working on a login application which have a login page. After login page, it will display let me preparing an application for a school. Okay, so login page. Okay, login page, and then it when I'm working on a student login page, when I will do after login page, the student's profile will be there. That what are the in details of a student. So the profile page will come. And then there was an navigation bar where it is home assignments or the practice paper or some such things are being there. Tabs for home assignment, tabs for this is there. So let me, I am working on this project. Now what I will do, let's have a sprint where we are dividing, if we have done it. Now in the sprint also, we will divide it a work into one. Three developers are working on this project. So first developer will have to create a login page. Second developer has to create a profile page. Third developer has to create assignment page. Okay. So now I have divided this work. These are the work items. Okay. So login page is the first work item, then profile page and this. So these are the work item. Now you can relate to your project also. Now your project is for this, suppose. So you can check that from your projects that what are the different work items depending on this. As you are working, you can correlate from Unison. So Unison is one where there is a work. If you click on the work items, screens of your.
Yeah, it developer. Shows me like something assigned to me.
Yes.
I mean, of course, there is a, I mean, in the work item, I think there is a, so wait, the work items goes from the board, right?
Yes, yes.
Below the board. And yeah, under board. Yeah, so it is just like activities basically showing like new work items which are assigned to me or that filter by.
Okay.
Whichever, like I said. That's what, right? That's what it work items.
Yeah. I have done a mistake. This is what it was. Let me open up. I will show you what is meant by work items. When I am sharing my screens, sometimes it. This is similar to the, have you seen a Jira board?
Jira, yeah, I have used it extensively.
You have used it, okay. So this is similar to Jira board. So if you see in a work item, now if you create a new item, so we have epic issue task, okay. So we can have a user story also. So these are the new work item. So epic issue task, that is one, what is it? Epic is the overall head. Under Epic, we have stories or the task. Okay. So if you see, so these work items are the, you can say work items are just like issues in Jira.
Jira, yeah.
Yeah, work items are just like issues in Jira. That is any project, any task given, what the task we are doing is a work item.
Yeah.
Okay. So then it's a board. So if you click on the board, it will have to do whatever it is, their work items. So these are the, this is just like a Kanban board. Okay, so if you click on your boards, you will see what are the item assigned to are in a to do or doing or done. Just click on your boards.
Yeah, in the board, it's, we have a kind of a Kanban. So we have a board where it's, like all the items are there.
Yes, yes. So it must be classified into to do or something like this.
Not in the to do, but it is
doing or some. What are the words? What are the headings they have taken? Because by default,
board, and after board, it's analytics.
Okay.
And below then it just says that in software design and estimations, development and test design, in test and done. So new, below there are like basically 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. First is new, then in software design and estimations.
Okay.
And I think it's like a category, development and test, test and then done.
Yeah. So the, because
I think this category, if I know, like I think they, like, we can define it.
Yeah, we can custom, define
right?
it. Yeah. We can change the categories instead of that. Yeah. What we want to be in a to do instead of to do, that is what the, you can change these categories.
Okay. Yeah.
as you know,
yeah, something like this. Yes, yeah, exactly similar to this, but instead
if you
of
go to the project project settings, sorry, I will just show you. I will, at the end, if you are seeing a project settings, so when you click on the project settings, if they say that yes, you want to make the changes in the Teams permission service tool.
For me, probably the, again, the access thing.
Yeah, access things.
So it is like name, descriptions, and process, Unison Scrum. And save button is disabled. Yeah.
So we can go to there, this project settings, and there we can make the changes that what we want in this our projects. So as you see, by default, it is to do, and let me go. Close this. To do, doing, and done. Otherwise, we can make it what you have told that I just saw analytics and test and what it is, and done. So done is the last one when we will close it. So it is. It can be modified as on that basis.
Project that settings, code. Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
When you go in the project settings, then project details, it is there. Then you have teams. Okay, in an overview, if you go this, all are on. If you make it off, if I will suppose I make it off, that means this artifacts will not be displayed in the screen on the overview of a project. Let me show you.
Sorry.
Okay. Remove artifacts. Okay, and let me say I have done a pipeline because I don't want these to be visible at present when I am not using this. So if you see, if I will, I have gone to my projects.
It's
now
gone.
You see, okay. It's gone. So that's why. So this will be come only when you will say, now if I make it on, I have make it on. Okay. So this is to delete a complete project. Now it will be displayed here. Okay. So this way we can make the changes. Teams.